Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Kyle Martin, and in today's video, we're gonna be getting ready for the 2021 Fall Art Tour. We didn't have a in-person Fall Art Tour last year. We had a virtual Fall Art Tour. The leaves are blowing off of that tree right behind me. During that time, Corbin and I worked hard, and we kind of got ourselves a little more established in the online world of selling paintings. But this is a new year and we're going back to an in-person tour this time around. This video is just gonna be a visual checklist of all the things that I need to do every year when I get ready for the Fall Art Tour. The things that we're gonna talk about is getting the studio ready to go. I had to get everything ready inside the chicken coop so that I could hang all of my paintings. We're gonna talk about selecting the paintings that I wanted to frame and hang on the walls. That's kind of a fun process. We're gonna talk about framing. There's a new framing situation going on this year. Sorry, I'm just like tightrope walking over Porter's leash as I'm saying that. I have an Amish cabinet maker who made me some really lovely frames and I'm excited to share those with you. I'm being distracted. Look at that fall foliage off in the distance. We're gonna talk about hanging the paintings up and tidying things up once they are hung. That's something that I've been working on this whole week and I'm gonna continue to work on more. We're gonna talk about the things that I do to keep my sanity during the busiest time of the year. Finally, we're gonna talk about making price cards for the paintings. I make these cool little cards that have a title of the painting, the dimensions of the painting, a description of the painting, and the price. Something jumping around in the water down there with Porter. I think there was like a frog or something down there. All right, so that's what we're doing in this video. Let's check it out. Let's have a little fun. This year, I really did a good job in keeping on track with getting the chicken coop ready for the Fall Art Tour. It's a big job. It's like a week-long process just to get this place transitioned into an art gallery. So normally during the year, I have all my skateboard ramps in here and it's an art gallery too at the same time. And it's a studio, but it takes a lot to get those skateboard ramps deinstalled and out of here so that I can make extra. And this year there was something happening out here in August that I had to prepare for. It's something that I haven't talked on this channel yet. I framed and hung a bunch of stuff about a month and a half ago, so it's lightened my load on things that I need to do this week while getting ready for the Fall Art Tour. It's raining outside. I don't know, I'm sure you can hear it. I always love the sound of rain. I wanted to take a minute and talk about the selection process for things that I want to frame up and hang in the chicken coop. When I first started painting and I had my first show, the thing that I did was just paint a ton of work and it worked out to being about two paintings out of every 8 or 10 would be frameable and would be something that I would put on display. Why do I say 2 out of 10 instead of like 1 out of 4? Well, sometimes you'll do 6 duds in a row and then you'll just come across a idea or a feeling that'll take you and you'll get a couple good ones at a time. Luckily, the thing is with painting is that you can get a little bit better through the years and my ratio of frameable paintings is a lot higher than it used to be. The thing that I still try to do is just paint a ton and then you're gonna have enough to fill up a show. So there's 4 components that go into any painting: drawing, values, colors, and edges. In this painting, the color and the atmosphere is kind of what the painting is all about, and that's why I decided to frame that one up. Same with this one, strong values, strong feeling of morning light. This piece up here, we've got some more graphic shapes. I tend to be a painter who enjoys breaking down the complex into the simplified. I think that in art, that's a good thing to do. You know, in poetry, that's a good thing to do. And this is a good example of that. The way that Devil's Lake is just a shape, the way that those rocks just become shapes. tape making.
A lot of times too, it's the landscape will be doing something that will
create an emotion inside of the painter, and that plays a part in it too. For instance, in this little piece down here, these Amish Otshaks, the late golden hour light just transformed everything, and to be able to set up the easel and capture that, it's just the what the landscape was doing, what Mother Nature was doing, was almost more important than anything that I was doing. There's beauty just in everyday life, and what the landscape is doing definitely has an effect on what I'm doing.
It's just like a little abstract of the river. These patches of water and the trees and everything else.
That was just some muddy day down by the river, but it still is special, and it still is worth celebrating, and it still is worth making a painting about. That's kind of how I make my selections of what I want to put on the wall, is just like, what was the emotion of the day? Was it a good emotion? Because that stuff is going to come through in the work.
Nice emotion of the day.
That was like a sleepy November kind of a day. The atmosphere was thick. Oh, here's this little painting.
In the video today, we're gonna check out the session where I created this little painting. And I wasn't sure about this when I brought it in the house, but, and the light is kind of bad on it right now. That's a little bit better. It's just a glowing red tree.
What could be better to paint than a glowing red tree?
I am painting an image this afternoon of a beautiful backlit red tree. I'm just observing my subject matter, and I'm mixing the colors that I'm going to use to create this painting. I'm just working to get the colors and the values mixed up that are present on my subject matter. Autumn time is a great time of year. This backlit red tree. I've seen this same tree. I drive down this road all the time on my way to school, and I've never made time to pull the car over and paint it. This year I'm just trying to, as the season is changing and as I'm so busy getting ready for the fall art tour, I'm just making time to paint all the things that I always see every year during the autumn time. I'm just not really looking for any more than what is in my line of fire, I guess. I'm not looking for anything more than what is right in front of me and what I can see on my ride to and from school. Yeah, red tree today, autumn time, love it. A lady just pulled over as well, and she asked me if I ran my car into a deer, and I said no. I told her that I was just looking at this tree. If a sheriff pulls up later and asks me and has any questions for me, I'll know why he's here. It's kind of hard to explain that you're an artist and you're setting up your easel and you're going to create a beautiful landscape painting. Well, what a rush. The light has failed. You can see that those clouds did end up rolling in, but that's okay because I was out here and I was on the ball, and it kind of looks like a bomb went off all around my easel because I just kind of exited the real world. And this is the painting that I came up with today. So this painting has a lot of color and a lot of transparency to create that color. You can see right behind me that the actual subject matter, that tree presented, well, at least earlier when the sun was out, the light was kind of shining through those red and yellow and green and orange leaves that were on the tree. And I worked quickly to mix those colors up and place them. Again, I start off with a palette knife. That's just because I know that some of these sessions are gonna go by so quickly and I wanna quickly build up the surface. It's not because I wanna have that kind of look to my paintings. I just know that right now I'm interested in throwing some thick paint onto the canvas. Hopefully it lands in the right place. I'm interested in painting quickly and capturing the beauty that is autumn. Is this a perfect painting? I don't know. We'll see. Maybe it'll go on a frame. Maybe it'll go on my wall. Maybe it'll even go on your wall. But that's not the point. It's just the journey. And it's the questions that we ask. And it's the answers that we formulate. And then it's throwing those answers away and re-asking new questions as well. And I'm heading home for dinner. Corbin made sweet potato curry. It's my absolute favorite dish. I'm so excited for that. Thanks so much for sticking with me in this beautiful season of autumn. We're gonna be doing a lot of painting, and I'll see you all soon. So framing, I have these really nice Amish made frames. Now this is a varnish surface. Anytime you transport your paintings, or even when you look at a frame, you're gonna get little dings in the frame sometimes. But I feel like paying extra to get some nice frames done was a great way to do it. You can see that it's pretty easy to do. I just have a little points driver, and you see that little black thing in the corner up there, like right there. I just use a points driver and I put the panel into the frame, and then just a simple wire on the back. This is the wire that I use, soft strand. It has a plastic coating over it, so you're not like constantly stabbing your fingers with little pieces of metal wire, which it sounds like it's just like a second consideration, but it took me 3 days to frame up. Why do I want to be sitting there for 3 days poking myself with wire? I don't want to do that. This is how I attach the wires, is just with these little D-rings. And then for anything that is a stretch canvas, I'll use these offset clips to secure the canvas into the frame. It's a lot of framing. I mean, it takes days. I used to think that I could frame a show and hang a show like within the same 24 hours and be painting right up to the line. But it's not really like that now. It takes me a long time to select the paintings and get them framed up. But I think that that's a part of it. And once everything is on the wall like it is now, then for the first time in the year, I get to kind of, the fall art tour week, it's like the 1 week out of the year where I have everything in my space that reflect on the body of work and see everything together. Isn't it lovely out here? But it's time for me and Porter to come out and have a little walk today.
Back when I had my skateboard shop, I would always release a new line of goods for the holiday season. I would have my own line of printed skateboard decks and hooded sweatshirts and t-shirts. For 2 years, I actually produced a catalog for all that stuff that I would send out to my mailing list. I would put a ton of work into doing that. And I can remember one day I was putting together, hand stapling these little, cutting out the catalogs with an X-Acto blade to size, scoring them with the X-Acto blade so they would fold nice, and putting them together to mail out. And I was doing it upstairs from where my skateboard shop was in the Chinese restaurant, because I was really good friends with Danny, who owned Eastern Chinese restaurant. And I just felt like I hit a wall. I know I was doing like 16 hour days getting ready for all this stuff. And yeah, for a lot of years of my life, I would just push through with these kind of creative projects and still do, you know, just like push straight through with them. I was just overworking myself to do all that stuff. Because of that, I have a much better perspective on the things that I need to do to keep myself going, to keep myself so that I can produce the best paintings that I can make, produce high quality work, so I can just keep going and actually be a happy person, because none of us started painting to work 16 hour days and to work straight through. I'm more like, work for a couple hours, take several hours off, and do something that you want to do. Walk in this loop. Look at how beautiful this yellow tree is right behind me. The color harmonies are really nice because there's like little purple branches around the trees. So we're on our walk because this is what we do. And oh no, Porter just saw a squirrel. We're out walking. It's a wonderful activity. I think that physical health is a very important component in your mental health, and I'm taking care of it right now. The other thing that I do that is kind of like my time is I'll go out skateboarding. Yesterday I skateboarded with Hess and April and Eric, and actually on the weekend, Eric and April and I went out and we had like a really good 3 hour session. It was just look at this. There's little grapevines growing up the tree. All that our bodies really want us to do is to be up moving around. And so going for walks, nothing makes me feel better than I feel after going for a walk. And for me, as a landscape painter, it's also not the worst thing ever, because I see stuff when I'm out walking and these synchronicities start to become clear to me. All that stuff comes to me when just out walking around with the dog. But why don't we check out some of that skateboarding footage as well, since we're on the topic of fun ways to get out of the studio. On my old Macintosh computer, and it's the only computer that I have that has the Creative Suite on it. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, Quark Express, Final Cut Pro. It's got all of the graphics and editing programs that I need on it.
I'm using Photoshop and I'm creating little, I call them price plaques. It's just a little price tag to hang below the paintings.
So what I'm doing is I'm titling all the paintings. I'm putting a price on all of the painting description tag plaque things.
This painting, which is up there, is called Phelps Farm Early Autumn. And it says, "It was the first day of fall when I set out to paint. I was on my way to another location when I noticed the backlit barn and cornfields and the shapes that they created. The more I looked, the more I saw, and I decided to paint here instead of my initial idea." And then it just says it's 12 by 16 inch. The painting is 12 by 16 inches. It's oil on canvas, and it's $790.
Yeah, that's just kind of a little accurate description of that day. That farm location, I haven't posted on my YouTube yet because I actually filmed a full demonstration video on that day.
People love those little price cards. They will come through the chicken coop, and some people will read a book. It kind of gives them an idea of just a few sentences on what I was thinking when I was making the painting.
That's what I'm doing for all the paintings that you see on the walls, is just creating a nice little price plaque for them. I call it a price plaque. It's whatever. I'm going to print out all these price cards, and then Corbin is going to laminate them so they're nice and they won't get ruined anyway, and the people can hang on to them forever. They can just tuck them onto the back of the painting or something like that. I've made 50 so far, and there's like 140 paintings, so I'm gonna keep cruising on this. I'm sitting on my Polymetrics box right here. This is my box that I use to do my leg jumps and all my leg exercises for skateboarding. And I started the fire, and I am just as cozy as can be on this October morning, sitting with the fire blowing right on me, just working at my computer. But it's these little moments every year that I start the fire for the first time. It's honestly really fun and a really good feeling.
One thought that has been on my mind and that has actually been making me feel really happy and inspired is just going to Chicago, and I'm going to treat myself and Corbin to a nice 2 or 3 or 4 days down in Chicago in a hotel, and that's just like some of my favorite memories. We usually try to go every year after the Fall Art Tour, and we like to go to the record store and the comic book store. We go skateboarding at Grant Park, and right across the street from the hotel that we stay at, there's a Calder statue, and it's just a granite plaza, and we skateboard through there. Corbin just turns into like a full-time skater when we go to Chicago. Just the best vegan restaurant is there. It's called Native. We stay like right next to it, so you know, maybe we'll have dinner and lunch out to eat when we're in Chicago, and we'll drink some boba tea in between. And that time of year, like November, December, is really cool because it's hoodie and jacket weather, but it's still, and maybe there's a little bit of snow, and the city is kind of has that atmosphere, just that cold city kind of atmosphere. And as I'm walking down Schneider Road here, I'm just kind of acting like I'm walking down Michigan Avenue and just thinking, you know, why this could be Michigan Avenue right here. This could be a granite plaza that I'm walking through right now. And that's gonna be a big reward at the end of it. Time with Corbin. God, during those times, it's just like, we just have so much fun. Walking around the Bean in Millennium Park. We went ice skating 1 year in December. And the stores all have like their Christmas displays out. There's a Dick Blick art store there, and it's huge. I think they have every product that is in the Dick Blick catalog in that Chicago store. I could spend all day there. I would probably go through every single pastel stick in the store and pick out the ones that are good. That's a cool thought. And go to the Chicago Art Institute as well. The last time we went there was a Manet show. That was kind of cool to see. There's such a beautiful collection of French Impressionism and Fauvism and everything else. American painting, the Sargents, go in there and catch a vibe from Monet's Haystack series. I used to go into the Art Institute and I would stand in front of the Monet paintings, especially the Haystacks, and I would sit there with my little Moleskine sketchbook and I would be writing down the color combinations that he's using to depict the light falling onto these haystacks. I just go and enjoy them. They have the whole modern wing there. Bonnard, Vuillard, Vincent van Gogh, Cezanne, Barth Morisot. Oh my gosh. Maybe we'll just rent out an apartment in Chicago for that month or something like that. I don't think Corbin would be able to take off from work. I probably wouldn't either.
Like I mentioned earlier, I've got some people coming out today to check out everything that's in the chicken coop. Actually, I think I have three different groups of people coming today. I'm just gonna tidy up this place a little bit. Honestly, the place looks really good. I just have to sweep the floor and just do a little in general tidying up. Keep in mind, I have to make a video next week while the Fall Art Tour is actually going on, so I'm saving a couple of the surprises until next week as well. So keep your eyes peeled for next week Friday, because I think you're gonna like it.